everybody, and welcome to the Tora Jordan Show. I'm your host, Tora Jordan. If you're new here, hey, welcome. If you're a returning viewer, hey, welcome back. Glad to see you. So today is a very special day. My big brother is getting married, and I'm standing in the middle of the sanctuary before anybody else gets here so I can show you this. That is their wedding arch and their unity cross for their ceremony, which I will film that and put that on my video. So anyway, today's a big day. I have no makeup on yet. My hair's done though. But yeah, been helping get everything ready to go, ready for a wedding. Let's go sneak into the fellowship hall and we'll see what the reception looks like. Okay, so we are in the fellowship hall. Place settings and everything. Of course, we don't have any of the extra little lights on yet. They've got up to a star. Here, I'll show you some more stuff before everybody else gets here. Okay, this is their cake table. Of course, the cake's not here yet. That is actually my brother's wood splitting tables that he butted up together to use as the cake table. And very special, this bottom piece is a double heart wood cookie. And then this is a single heart wood cookie. So it's two becoming one. Y'all can't tell me my brother's not as happy romantic. And then this is their table. Here, let me flip the camera around. And of course, my brother's favorite saying, Mach 2 with my hair on fire. And then her favorite saying, just breathe. I'm going to give you all a little more view of the table setup. And then, of course, the gift table and card corral. And her mom got him a marriage prayer. Let me see if I can get it to where y'all can pause to read. But anyway, there we go. That's the reception hall. And of course, up there we have an overflow room for extra room. But yeah, very sweet, very simple, very country. So the best man printed this up for my brother, and Tiana doesn't know yet. So there you go. He's not as happy romantic at all. Not at all.
Bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh, she shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doth faithfully trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, God, we thank you, Lord, for your many blessings. God, we thank you, Lord, for these two people here, Lord, that they've come to join in this union. Father, we thank you, Lord, for all the friends and family that have come this way to celebrate this joyous occasion. Now, Father, we ask you, Lord, as we begin the ceremony, Lord, that you would have your way throughout the whole entire thing. God, that your life would be glorified. God, that you would be glorified. We love you. We thank you. We praise you. Amen. Amen. Peter, Scripture says to you, husbands, love your wife, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. And Tiana, the Scripture says to you, wives, submit yourselves unto your husbands as unto the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. And to you both, the Scripture says, submit yourselves one to another in fear of God. A union embodying such ideals is not to be entered into lightly or unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, soberly, and in the fear of God. Into such a union you now come to be joined. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? You all may be seated. Before God and these witnesses, will you, Peter, take Tiana to be your wife? Will you love and comfort her, honor and keep her, and in joy and sorrow preserve her with this bond, holy and unbroken until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, or as long as you both shall live? Before God and these witnesses, will you, Tiana, take Peter to be your husband? Will you love and comfort him, honor and obey him, keep him, and joy and sorrow preserve him? This bond holy and unbroken until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, or as long as you both shall live. Peter, repeat after me. I, Peter, take you, Tiana.
I, Peter, take you, Tiana.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To love you with all of my heart's affection.
To love you with all my heart's affection.
To endow you with all my earthly possessions.
To endow you with all my earthly possessions.
To give you the honor of my name.
To give you the honor of my name.
And to share with you the grace of my God.
To share with you the grace of my God.
All right. Tiana, repeat after me. I, Tiana, take thee, Peter,
to be my husband.
Whither thou goest, I will go.
And where thou lodgest, I will lodge.
Thy people shall be my people, and thy God, my God. At this time, the couple is going to do the unity cross. At this time, Peter and Tiana will assemble the Unity Cross, a beautiful sculpture they will display in their home to remind them of the covenant they are making today. Genesis chapter 1, verse 27 says, "So God created man in his own image, and the image of God created he him." That means he created man bold, strong, to be a protector of his whole family. The outer form of the Unity Cross represents the strength, leadership, and protection of the man. Ephesians 5:25 states, "Husbands, love your wife, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it." A husband is to give himself totally and completely for his wife. Genesis 2:20-23 tells us, "And Adam gave names to all cattle and to all the fowl of the air, to every beast of the field. But for Adam there was not found an helpmeet for him. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept, and he took one of the ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from man made him woman, and brought her to the man. And Adam said, 'This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man.'" The bride's piece of the Unity Cross represents the beauty and the many capabilities of the woman, designed with intricate, beautiful detail, and is placed inside the protection of the groom's cross, completing the sculpture and representing the two becoming one. Representing the couple's covenant, we are placing three pegs to hold it together. These pegs represent the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, showing God's place in the covenant and security and completeness that only the Heavenly Father can give. Withstand him, and a threefold cord is not easily broken. It's this thing that Peter and Tiana, if you've done today, you guys are asking, "I need to say something," to go ahead and say it. And this will be a reminder on the days when it's hard, the days whenever you're not feeling the best, the days that, you
know, you're not able to give the 50%, 50-50. And God's always going to be there, and you all together are going to be there. But with God in the middle, that it will last forever. As a token of this covenant, you will now give and receive the marriage rings. I'll get it. I'll just get it in just a second. The unbroken circle, the emblem of eternity, and the gold, the emblem of that which is least tarnished and most enduring, are to show how lasting the pledge you have made each. You have each made to the other. With these emblems of purity and endless devotion, you each other wed, and these marriage vows you here and now forever seal. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you again, Lord, for the ceremony. We thank you, Lord, for these two and the families that came this way. Father God, we thank you, Lord, for you being real to each one of these two, Lord Father. God, we thank you, Lord, that you lead their lives. God, that they placed you in there. God, we thank you, Lord, for salvation. Lord God, we ask you, Lord, you continue to bless this union as they go with the rest of their lives. God, that they'll always see you in everything. And God, that you'll always uphold them, Lord, as we know you will. We love you. We thank you. We praise you. Amen. Inasmuch as you, Peter, and you, Tiana, have thus consented in holy matrimony and have witnessed the same before God and these friends, by virtue of the authority vested in me as the minister of the word of God and by the laws of this state, I now pronounce you husband and wife. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. You may kiss your bride. Now pronounce you Mr. and Mrs. Peter Rhodes.
Oh yes, be nice. She has to look pretty. Oh, he was nice to you.
Well, the bride has been kissed and the marriage license has been signed and they're off on their honeymoon and the reception hall is all cleaned up. So, that's the adventure that we had on Saturday. Y'all are beautiful or handsome, depending upon. I care for you guys. You're not alone. Be kind to yourself and be kind to others. Congratulations, Peter and Tiana. Love ya!